So good morning students, I hope you are doing great. Okay, so before starting the class I would like to give you an instruction. Whenever Miss Joanne and I ask a question, I request you all to unmute yourself and answer them. Okay, let's start. So I have a question, students. Can you tell me like who is an archaeologist?
Archaeologists, they unearth historical
monuments.
Yes, they find the historical monuments. Very good. Anything else?
They excavate.
They study the artifacts that they find in historical sites.
Yes, yes, right, Prabha. Thank you. So, can you tell me, students, one historical site that is located in Punjab and Pakistan? I've given you hint also.
Mohenjo-daro.
Yes, very good. One more. The famous
Harappa.
Yes, yes, very good, thank you. So it's called Harappan civilization. Can you tell me how did the civilization get the name Harappa?
No, miss.
Okay, so the Harappa is a place located in Punjab. Okay, since the excavations are found in the Harappa, they are called Harappan civilization. Okay, so there is also the another name used for Harappan civilization. Can someone tell me that? It's a river name.
Indus Valley civilization.
Yes, very good. Indus Valley civilization. As you see here, Mohenjo-daro is here and the Harappa is here and it is along the river Ravi. Okay, and this entire part is called the Indus Valley civilization, extend from the northeast Afghanistan to into Pakistan and the north West India, that is Punjab. Okay, so students, tell me, why is this Harappan civilization is important in Indian history? Why do you think we are studying this? Do you think it is important for the Indian history?
Yes, we understand how our ancestors lived.
Yes, very good. We understand the lifestyles of our forefathers, everything. Yes, very good. So does you are aware about the origin of the Harappan civilization, which is one of the Asian civilizations of the world? Today we shall study about the two forms of arts that is used by the people in the lesson Harappan civilization. In this lesson we shall study about the seals and the earthen pots used by the people. Over to Ms. Joanne.
Okay, so students, what do you see here in this image?
Seals of different kinds.
Yes, so these are the seals that are used today. And why do you think seals are used? Why do people use seals? For what purpose?
To attach some sort of proof or some sort of evidence.
Very good.
A particular document.
Yeah. So as you see, these official documents usually have seals. So seals are used to, seal up official documents and important documents. So students, if you go to your school notice board and you check your principal's message, it will always have a seal. It will always have her stamp and her signature over there. Okay. So why is that so?
Because it is the official notice.
Yes, because it is an official document. So students, similarly, Harappan people also had seals during their time. So they used to make a sealing or a positive imprint, okay? And these seals were used for the purpose of trade and even to seal their official documents when they had to send it to another city, okay? So their seals were made of a metal called steatite, which is also called soapstone today. Okay, students? So, Miss Gracie, do you think they know the difference between a Harappan seal and a modern seal?
Of course, Miss Joanne. Yes.
Now, okay, let's find out if they know
about it. Yes, yes. Okay. So, here you see, students, on the left, you see the Harappan seal and on the right, you see the modern seal. So, can you tell me what's the difference you find between them?
The Harappan seals were carved into
stone. Can you repeat again, please?
The Harappan seals were carved into stone or made using clay.
Yes, very good. And what's the different? What do you see on the modern one?
They are imprinted.
Imprinted.
Yes. So can someone tell me how do we use the modern one, students?
We melt the wax and then we pour the wax on the paper and then we take the stamp and then keep it for some time till it dries up.
Yes, very good. And what's the shape? How's it shaped, students? Do you see any difference in the shape between the modern and the urban seal?
Yes, the urban seals are more geometrical, square
in shape.
Yes, very good, square. Whereas modern, the modern is
circular
manner. Yes, in urban seals are squares in what is modern is circular in manner. And what do you see on the seal in the urban seal? Do you see any images?
Yes,
it
depicted the lifestyle of the people.
Yes, very good. You see the large size animal and it also depicts the lifestyle of the people. Very good. Very good. So, if you see in urban seals, usually feature a single large animal such as elephant, rhinoceros and the buffaloes. Okay. And they also feature the unicorn on the Indus seal. Okay, usually they're depicted in the profile manner and sometimes they are shown standing alongside the feeding troughs. Okay. Over to Miss Joanne. She'll talk about the more about the seal.
Miss Gracie, you forgot to tell them about the Pashupati seal that is in Delhi.
Yes, Miss.
Yes. So I will tell them about
it. Yes, sure.
Okay, students. So there is a seal called a Pashupati seal. Miss, can you display the image?
Yes, yeah.
Yes. So this is the Pashupati seal. It is a stelite seal, which, as we discussed. Again, it is square in shape, okay? And it was discovered at Mohenjo-daro during the Indus Valley civilization. So the seal depicts a seated figure. So the seated figure is a deity, okay? Someone that the people back then used to worship. And it is trisphalic, that is, it has three heads. As you see here, the seal has three heads. And it has a very elaborate crown over it, okay? And what else do you notice in the seal around the
animals?
Yes, there are also various animals and the horn deities over there. And this seal is displayed at the National Museum of India, that is in New Delhi. Okay, students. So that is it for the seals. Miss Gracie, apart from seals, did they find anything else during the excavations?
Yes, miss. Now we'll talk about that. Okay. Yes. They also found the pots. Okay. Students, you see the two different here also. We have to compare. On the left, you see the present day pots, and on the right, you see the urban pots. Can you tell me what's the difference you find here, students?
Today, we use plastic in making pots.
Yes, very good, Misha. Anything else? Yeah, plastic. Present day we use plastic, whereas in olden days, what do we use?
Earthen pots
made of clay.
Yes, they are made of clay. Okay. So, which is harmful, students? Is it present day pots are harmful or olden day pots are harmful?
Present day pots.
Present day pots. How they are harmful to the environment?
Because
they are made of plastic.
So, they are not biodegradable.
Yes, whereas in olden days, there were no plastic. So, they used to make with the help of clay. Okay. What's the difference you see other than the materials,
the designs on the design. Ancient pots.
Okay, very good. And you know, if you see in the present day, all the pots are similar, right?
Yes.
What do we use these pots for?
Collecting or storing water.
Water. We usually use for storing the water. Whereas here, you see various types shapes you see, and what do we use? If you see one, we use for storing the grains, another you use for storing the water, and we also use to draining of the water. It's used for various purpose, for household purpose. That is why we see the varieties of pots. Okay, nowadays we don't use pots usually, but in olden days all the storage thing, even in order to use something, they use pots. Okay, that's why we see varieties of pots here. Okay, so as you all mentioned, it is made up of clay. Can you tell me any two characteristics of the clay, students?
It can be molded.
Yes, very good. Molded. Anything else?
it can
is it be freely available or is it very difficult to find?
It is easily available.
It is freely available, universally found. Okay, you can see clay on the river banks, agricultural land, and the lakes. Okay, it's a part of the earth's crust. Anything else, students?
It can be baked to make it long lasting. It can be painted.
Yes, very good. Can be long lasting. Okay, so least perishable of all materials. Okay, so once we make this pot, it can be for a very long time. We can use it unless we don't break it. Okay. So it is easy to make and it is easy to find also. So in olden days, people used to make clay pots because it is available everywhere. This is free of cost. So now here you see images of the pots. Now look carefully on the design, students, and tell me what you see on the slide, on the pot.
Again, there is animal.
Animal is there, okay.
And we've drawn some symbols.
Symbols, very good. And what do you see in down, students, here?
A very elaborate design.
Very elaborate, right? Yes, you see the semicircle, geometrical figures. It's very well designed, isn't it?
Yes, miss.
So, in olden days, they used to do a well-designed work. And these pots, which we are saw in previous slide, were found in Mohenjo-daro, okay, which is which is found in 1921, a place about 650 kilometers down to the south of Arapa in the Indus Valley. Over to Ms. Joanne.
Okay, students. So, students, a large quantity of pottery excavated from the sites of the Indus Valley, they were chiefly they were very fine and they were made with the wheel, okay? And very few of them were actually handmade. So plain pottery is more common than the painted ware. So one of the main reasons for making handmade clay objects is for household purpose. Therefore, it is found in many shapes and sizes and patterns. So perforated pottery includes a large hole at the bottom and small holes all over the walls, and was probably used for straining beverages. The ancient people also began with a well-mixed lump of clay and started working with their fingers to give them different shapes and forms. Okay, students, so as you see here, we don't only find the traditional pots. There are various shapes and forms of the pots and they are very uniquely made. And what used to be the skill during Harappan civilization is an occupation and means of livelihood for many tribal communities in modern times. But students, today we are not using these pots for the purpose that they are meant to serve. So today, with the impact of plastic, which is proving to be very harmful for the environment, we need to once again go back to our roots and start using clay pots for the betterment of mankind. Okay, students? So, now, Ms. Gracie will talk about these different tribes that actually make these pots and their livelihood thrives because of these pots. Over to you, yes. Ms. Gracie.
Yes, thank you, Ms. Joanne. So, if you see, Ms. Joanne talked about a lot about the pots, okay? And the images we collected, your students, have been collected from the arpan.com website, okay? And we would like to show you that. And Ms. Joanne put on the chat box the link.
Yes, miss.
Okay, yes. So here is the arapa.com. Okay, you'll be getting the link also on the chat box. So if you click on the home page, here you see the various images. You have to just click on here and here you get the arpan pots and the objects. We also talked about the unicorn seal. You get the images here. We collected some images here only. You can just click on it and you'll get the descriptions of it. See, you get a description. So, for more information, you can also go here. Okay, students? Yes. Now, let's go to the presentation. So, now let's look at the tribes who are still doing this pots work. If you see in Madhya Pradesh, there are two tribes, Jammu and Bastra. They are doing the clay temples. You see here the clay temples, okay, which has a small door where the godly figure is placed along with the fire lamp. And in Tamil Nadu, Ayyanar community, they make a giant looking figures of horse and elephant. It is believed that the villagers believe that the goddess will sit on the figures, and they will protect the village. Okay, so these are the two people. This not only these two communities, even many tribal people in the rural areas are making poles as their occupation. That is their livelihood. Object is made. Okay, as Clarice mentioned, it is dried in the sun, and after drying, it is fired in a local kiln at a very high temperature. Okay, and once it is fired, and you get this kind brown colored pot, which is strong, imperishable and durable. Okay, that you can use it for the household purposes. So once you make a clay, you can't pour water into it because it is not hard, and it will break. Whereas once you go into the process of drying and the firing, the pots become very strong, and that pot is called red terracotta pots. Okay, that is why we see 5,000 year old seals and the earthen pots which are still available in the excavation site, and we also saw in the arpan.com also they are still, which are still visible. That's because of the this process the pots have gone through. Okay, so over to Ms. Joanne.
Okay, students. So the pots found at these sites, as you see here, have patterns like fish. Then intertwined or interlocked circles and people leaves and etc. Okay, so these are the type of pots, and these are the different patterns that you see at the pots that were found at the site. Miss, can you please change the slide?
Yes.
Okay. So students, can you tell me how clay is used in everyday life? Which are the materials that are used that are made with clay?
Show pieces.
Very good. Show pieces. Yes.
Pottery.
Very good.
Ornaments can be made.
Diyas, ornaments. Yes. Very good. Miss, can you display the images? Yes. Okay. So, can you tell me why we use these things? The first one, the earthen pot.
Because it has a cooling effect on
it. It has a cooling effect, and it is used to store water. Okay. The second one is used to store food. The third one, these are tiles that are used at different places. So these are mostly preferred because they have a very cooling effect. Okay, and they're good for the environment as well. Okay, students. So these items are often in great demand. Okay. And during the festive seasons and even at various ceremonies, we see people using it. So during a cremation ceremony, when you see the person who is dropping the pot, the person also is using a pot over there. Then even at festivals, you see diyas being used. Okay, so there are various uses of it. Okay, students. So apart from that, the Harappan people also, when they buried their dead, they used to bury earthen pots along with the bodies. Okay, they used to bury earthen pots, and the pots sometimes contained food as well. So these objects were meant to be a grave offering for the dead because they also believed in life after death. Okay, students. So now I request Miss Gracie to take over.
Yes. So today we studied about the two forms of art used by the Harappan people, seals and pots. And under the seals, we looked into the square-shaped seals. And we also saw the images of different animals and human figures also. We also studied about the stamps. Okay. How the seals are used as the stamps. Whereas in the pots, we studied the various types and shapes that are found at the excavation site. We studied about the red terracotta pots and how these pots are also buried along with the dead bodies. Okay, now it's time for evaluation. Over to Ms. Joanne.
Yes, students, let's test your ability. Okay. So, can you tell me where were the earthen pots of various types and shapes found? Where were they found?
Harappa,
Mohenjo-daro.
Yes, at archaeological sites, excavation sites. Okay. So, explain the features of the Harappan seals.
They were made of clay. They depicted animal figures, and yes, they were square in shape.
Okay, a good attempt, but we also have to remember that they were made from steatite and not clay. Steatite is a metal. Okay, so today we call it as soapstone. So let's revise. It was made, it was square shaped, it was made from steatite, and it included pictures of different animals and human figures. Okay, so what patterns are seen on the Harappan pots?
Fish patterns.
Yes.
The lockings of even geometrical shapes.
Yeah, sometimes even geometrical shapes. But we'll stick to fish scales, interlocking circles, and people leaves. Okay. Why did the Harappan people bury the earthen pots?
As an offering.
Yes, very good. Okay, as a grave offering to their dead. Okay, student, you have to read up on the other civilizations that existed in other parts of the world during the Harappan period and mark it on the outline of the world map. Okay, you have to take a world map and read up and find other civilizations that existed, and you have to mark it on the world map. Okay, thank you, students, for being such an interactive class and for responding so well. We shall meet in our next class. Thank you, students. Thank you.
Thank you, miss.
Thank you, miss.